How often does it happen to you that you are sitting down to solve a trigonometry question and you wonder whether sine is opposite by adjacent or hypotenuse by adjacent or something else? Truth is that as a teacher, I too get confused at times. In this video, I will share the techniques I used to remember these trigonometric ratios and some of their values. Some people have curly black hair through proper brushing. Now, that is not only an easy way to get curly black hair, that is also my acronym for remembering trigonometric ratios. Say for your triangle, this angle considered as the reference angle, theta, and you name your side as perpendicular and base and hypotenuse. By then, using this acronym, you can easily recollect the trigonometric relations. Some people have curly black hair through proper brushing. So, using the first letter of each word, we get sine is equal to perpendicular by hypotenuse, cos is equal to base by hypotenuse, and tan is equal to perpendicular by base. This does the trick every single time. And we know that cot is reciprocal of tan, sec is the reciprocal of cos, and cosec is the reciprocal of sine. But instead of using the terms perpendicular and base and hypotenuse, if you are of the habit of calling the sides of the triangle as opposite, adjacent and hypotenuse, don't worry, we have got that covered as well. Silly old Hitler could not advance his troop over Africa. That sad history lesson somehow helped our math lesson. Silly old Hitler could not advance his troop over Africa. Again, taking the first letter of each word, sine is opposite by a hypotenuse, cos is adjacent by hypotenuse, and tan opposite by adjacent. Then we have the reciprocal ratios. The next big challenge is to memorize the standard value of trigonometric ratios. We are normally required to memorize the trigonometric ratios for standard angles like 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90. I use my 5 fingers to remember these values. First, we assign one angle to each finger. This is 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90. So this is the technique I used for sine. I say sine of a particular angle is equal to root of number of finger below the angle by 2. For 0 degree, there are no finger below this finger. So sine is root of 0 by 2, that is equal to 0. For 30 degree, there is one finger below. So sine 30 is root of 1 by 2, that is equal to 1 by 2. For 45 degree, we have two fingers below this finger. Therefore, root 2 divided by 2 is 1 by root 2. Sine 60, there will be 3 fingers. Therefore, root 3 divided by 2. Then, sine 90, there are 4 fingers below. Therefore, root 4 divided by 2, it is equal to 1. For cos, we write the values we got for sine in the reverse order. So we have cos 0 is 1, cos 30 is root 3 by 2, cos 45 is 1 by root 2 and cos 60 is 1 by 2, cos 90 is 0. As an another trick for cos, we could also count the number of fingers above the angle. But don't get confused with the sine and cos being above or below. Just remember that when you sign a document, we always sign below. Sine is opposite by hypotenuse and cos is adjacent by hypotenuse. So if we divide sine by cos, we get sine by cos equal to opposite by adjacent, and that is tan. So to get the value of tan, we divide the corresponding values of sine and cos. So tan 0 will be sine 0 by cos 0 equals 0. Tan 30 will be 1 by 2 by root 3 by 2 equals 1 by root 3. Similarly, on dividing, we get tan 45 equals 1, tan 60 equals root 3. Now, tan 90 will be sine 90 by cos 90, that is 1 by 0. Dividing anything by 0 gives infinity. So, tan 90 is infinity. For the rest of the ratios, we know that cot is the reciprocal of tan, sec is the reciprocal of cos, and cosec is the reciprocal of sine. Most people hate trigonometry because there is so much to be heard and for no particular reason. We have solved one of the problems here. You no longer are by hurting all these relations and their values. These tips for memorizing can help you a lot in maths. And once you give hating maths a rest, you will start to see maths around you and how this can be used in activities around us. So, give maths a chance. Let your imagination grow. Happy learning.